All right, guys, this is for seventh graders. Your next two songs are going to be 113 and 114 in the book. So I wanted to just address the issue that the violins are going to have. So you may want to practice 108 to 112 first, because that's going to just review the low fourth finger for you. Okay, so you could try 112 would be like your B flat scale, but the upper octave, which is very similar to the E flat scale, right? Using low fours and you can't play opens. So 112 would look like this for violin, starting on a low one. And then you go back down, okay? So 113 starts on that low four B flat for violins, and it looks like this. Very similar like that. The trick to getting this in tune is leaving that low one down as long as possible. Okay, you don't have to move it until the end of the second line, and then you can keep your low one down again until the end of the fourth line. Okay, 114 I think for violins is a little easier because you can play open A, and again it's same low ones and low twos, only finger on the tape is three. So now what I want to do is I just want to show you on for viola, it's the same notes as the other song you guys did. So low one, low two, you have B flat and E flat. And then on cello, it's very similar as well. But I heard a lot of mistakes on the last one. So I just want to show you how that one would look again, okay? So I'll do 114 because they're all really similar, okay? So it looks like this. So you're starting on a two for B flat. But then regular one for A, so be careful. Lift, then low one. Regular one. And you shouldn't be playing three at all in that cellos, okay? And again, viola, you're going to have the low one on the D, the low one on the A, but regular one on the G string for A for a singer, okay? And basses, you should be in half position the whole time on both of these songs. Alrighty, thanks guys, have fun.